Crash 4 is finally here, the game that was announced this summer and released in October. It's honestly insane how much little time has passed since the announcement to it being in our hands, but here we are. However, this game's development team wasn't Vicarious Visions, the creators of the Crash Bandicoot and Insane Trilogy. Instead, they had their hands full with another awesome remake, the Tony Hawk Pro Skater 1 and 2. However, we do have Toys for Bob, the creators of that awesome Toys of Life franchise Skylanders, and the brains behind the pretty good Spyro Reignited Trilogy working on top of Crash Bandicoot 4. The trailers leading up to release were nothing short of awesome, and needless to say, as a 3D platformer fan and as a Crash fan, I was really excited to delve in. So enough chit chat, let's get straight into Crash Bandicoot 4 just in time. Crash 4 picks up right where Crash 3 leaves off. We see the villains Entropy and Neocortex trapped in an alternate dimension with Aku Aku. After Aku Aku puts in the effort of sacrificing himself to open a dimensional rift, the two villains leave and start their crusade across multiple dimensions and timelines in their effort to rule over the entire universe. Back at Crash's world over at Insane Beach, stuff starts acting up, causing Crash and Coco to investigate. They stumble across Lakulanu, one of the four quantum masks, and quickly realize the dimensions are being scrambled due to nefarious villains. So they get to work, no questions asked, leaping through the quantum portal and starting our insane platforming adventure. Crash Bandicoot 4 is beautiful. I'd go as far to call this game as the 3D Cuphead in terms of its fluid animations. It plays a ton with squash and stretch, which makes platforming and exploring feel fluid and kind of wacky at times to control. Mix that with a top tier locked 60fps frame rate with out of this world color design and vibrant level locations, and of course top notch level design, it all sets up for one of the best looking games I've ever played. I just love how varied the level locales are and how the character animations, from the overly exaggerated character deaths to the enemy movement patterns, all sets up for one incredible experience that looks as great as it is in motion, as well as it plays. Also, the soundtrack is as good as ever. It's the standard Crash affair, doesn't try to stray too far from the norm, with tons of percussion and tingy beats, kind of jungle sounding music, but that doesn't mean there aren't a lot of surprises here too. There's certain worlds or levels that offer more jazzy fiesta type songs, along with a nice techno style, which I won't spoil which world that is in, but you guys get the gist here. The tracks on display are really great, and it all sounds awesome. Accessibility is huge in games like this and for games to come, and thankfully Crash 4 comes through in regards to accessibility. From various subtitles and colorblind modes, this all allows the game to just be a little bit easier for people that have those kinds of issues. Along with making the game easier on players with a retro and modern mode, retro giving you the classic live system where you have to collect lives and all that jazz, where modern instead gives you infinite lives but at the cost of restarting checkpoints and only allowing 3 deaths per level clear if you go for 100%. I think these are all great ways to enjoy the game, and it helps everyone complete the game at their own pace, so I don't see any knocks to be given here. Now we're at the meat and potatoes of any video game, and this time it's the hardcore platforming that Crash Bandicoot 4 has to offer. And Crash 4 comes out swinging. Keeping the heart and soul of the original Crash trilogy, the slide jump spin attacks, and that tight linear platforming we're all fans of, Toys for Bob decided to go out of their way to carve their own path into Crash's identity, and that's easily the best aspect of Crash 4. It rarely relies on nostalgia through its gameplay. A lot of the worlds are created, they're unique to Crash 4. Playing through them never really gives off that vibe of been here, done that. Thankfully, that's not to say there aren't any flashbacks or anything of that nature. They do try to harken back to the retro era with flashback levels and retro costumes throughout, but it's more so a new experience that's awesome to check out because it's a brand new Crash adventure with brand new levels that we haven't experienced before, the likes of those being extremely difficult. This game's platforming reminds me a ton of indie bangers like Celeste, Super Meat Boy, and games of that nature, where every mistake that you make is often due to player error, where you have to make a lot of tons of split-second, frame-perfect platforming decisions to get past levels. Now, on a normal run, this isn't too bad, doubly so if you play on modern mode. All you gotta do is clear the level, grab some fruit every once in a while, and learn the patterns, and voila! The game is complete, your level's done, and you move on. But on a completionist run, which you usually do for a second playthrough regardless, it's a living nightmare. Boxes on those hard to reach spots need to make perfect jumps in rapid succession with no room for error, bonus levels that leave me kind of head scratching on how to complete them for 100% box rate, and yes, even having to replay levels inverted or reversed, along with replaying levels with different characters who have different movesets and things so you can grab different box pickups, the likes of which have new obstacle sets up for one really, really hardcore 100% completion rate. Sure, I could complain about some of the sus hit detection that pops up from time to time, along with some kind of awkward camera angles not being able to really judge where I'm dropping a crash staple. But in reality, they're so few and far between, I can't really get too upset. I was frustrated with Crash 4 because it was mainly player error when it came to me messing up certain jumps. The precision required to beat these levels is absolutely insane, and when the Quantum Masks introduce themselves into the game, the level design opens up Pandora's box. Having to slide upside down through tiny gaps while flipping perfectly to return back to normal is beyond satisfying to pull off, for landing up platforms just right so you could slow down time grabbing the necessary boxes you need, and also hopefully hitting that coveted checkpoint, giving yourself a chance to breathe. Using the Dark Matter spin to gain a little bit of extra hype, but not making too many stakes trying to get those hard to read jumps and bounce off and then fly again, it all sets up for one invigorating platforming experience. The masks were a wise choice in level design, and it really goes to show here, a much welcome change akin to all the type of vehicle levels they tried throwing in future Crash entries. It just focuses on the hardcore platforming, more so of Crash 1 and 2, and I definitely applaud them for that, although maybe a couple vehicle sections would be nice just to harken back to Crash 3 Warped, eh? Further adding on to gameplay, there's a multitude of characters to play as well. You have Tanwa, whose gimmick is a bit slower paced version of Crash and Coco, focusing more on split second grappling hook movement and wall jumping segments. Dingo, who's a run and gun puzzle solver, sucking boxes up with a vacuum and shooting them back at enemies, activating switches and levers, followed by Neo Cortex, who uses his ray gun and dash abilities to make platforms ranging from intangible to static to bouncy, the likes of which you'll have to combine with dashes to keep moving on the fly. Add in a dose of that good old collect-a-thon gameplay, the likes of which has changed drastically from the original. It's a lot more streamlined. Thank you, Toys for Bob, for that, making 100% a lot more manageable. All you have to do is grab 60 to 70% of Wampa Fruit in a level, break all the boxes, find a hidden gem, and don't die past 3 times, and you get 100% collection in those levels. Doing so nets you some sweet skins for Crash and Coco, and a much better reward than those bragging rights in previous games, at least in my opinion. Crash 4 offers some of the tightest platforming segments I've played in years in any AA or AAA platforming game, and it's jam-packed with tons of levels and content, not to mention the replay value that comes with finishing the game is by far the best value you can get on the market. This is one of my favorite games of the Crash series, if not my all-time favorite, maybe time will tell, but I just enjoyed it a lot more than previous entries, and if you're a Crash fan, something tells me you will too. Crash 4 is a superb platformer that took me by complete surprise. I was expecting another Crash 3 Warped or honestly Wrath of Cortex, something with tons of vehicle sections and emphasis on wacky power-ups because of those masks, but instead we got something more akin to Crash 2 and 1, where it's just a hard focus on tight moment-to-moment platforming that makes completing levels a rewarding experience. If you love platformers, you can't go wrong with Crash 4, and I really recommend it to anyone who's looking for an awesome platforming adventure. And that's gonna do it for this review. Thank you all so much for coming out to the channel and supporting my Crash Bandicoot 4 review. If you have any thoughts on Crash Bandicoot 4, please rattle them off in the comment section down below. If you're excited for more DLC or updates, whatever they're gonna do for this game, let me know. I'm actually very curious to see if we're gonna get some level packs or something, because it's a really awesome game and they can really expand upon it thanks to our modern hardware. And on top of all of that, if you enjoyed the content, make sure you leave a like, comment, and subscribe down below so you can keep it locked here for not just brand new reviews, but also next-gen tips and tricks that's going to be coming this November. Have a great rest of your day, guys. I'll see you next time. Peace.